Hello, my name is Martin, and welcome to Inside the Olympics with Richard Pound. Today, we're going to talk about professional athletes coming to the games. I hope you enjoy this video. You know, talking about team sports, we can't get away from now talking about professional athletes coming to the Olympic Games, because that happened, and that was kind of, you know, let's just say not everyone agreed originally. how did that come about?
Well, the sport in the sort of the late 19th century, early 20th, was kind of captured by a crowd that believed in a mythical amateurism that they said existed in ancient Greece, which it didn't. But you know, the true blue amateur was the only way to go, and they held on to that. I remember, as late as 1960, when I was training for the Olympics, I could not take a job as a lifeguard at a pool, because under the amateur code, that made me a professional. And I, somehow, if I sat out in a hot sun trying to keep kids from drowning, that gave me an advantage in swimming, which I never understood, but I wasn't going to rock the boat and miss the Olympics. But anyway, eventually we started to work towards a variation on those rules. A lot encouraged by the East Bloc countries, because they didn't have, or said they didn't have, professional sports. And I'd say by 1977 or so, the word amateur no longer appeared in the Olympic Charter. And so you had this kind of goofy situation. You don't have to be an amateur. You just can't be a professional. You say, oh, come on, give me a break. What is the difference? But anyway, we gradually worked toward that. And it was very interesting. The first dream team in basketball, that was the... was in Barcelona.
Yes.
And the NBA allowed its players to participate. And more importantly, the International Federation of Basketball had come to the conclusion that you could watch Michael Jordan films until the tide came in, but you'd never have the experience of playing against him on a court. So they said, if we're all going to get better, you know, the rising tide, let's allow the professional players to play and we'll learn from them. And sure enough, you know, everyone said, well, the Americans are going to win all the time. They said, yes, probably for a while. And in Barcelona, the Americans won. And it was very exciting to see, because normally there's a lot of, you know, bad mouthing, you know, between basketball teams before the games start. Not here. That I forget who was in the finals in Barcelona, but they were all, and when they introduced the team, they all ran over to have their picture taken beside Michael Jordan and Magic Johnson and so on. And so in 1992, the U.S. won. In 1996, at home in Atlanta, the U.S. won. In 2000, in the finals, the U.S. was in the finals. It was behind at halftime. And it was behind to France.
Whoa.
Think about that. So they won. But in 2004 in Athens, the U.S. didn't even get a medal. And so in the meantime, the you know, basketball around the world grew up and expanded its capacity beyond what anyone had imagined. So now it's kind of anybody's a game in these international tournaments.
I hope you enjoyed this video on Inside the Olympics with Richard Pound. Please remember to subscribe to our channel, press the like button, and if you wish to receive more videos like this, press on the notification bell. If you'd like to, please leave a comment. We would enjoy hearing from you.